In this video, we are talking about what is normal blood sugar. Hi, I'm Dr. Zarowski from NewVisionExcel.com. If you're new to the channel, it is such a pleasure to have you here. Be sure to subscribe, hit that little bell notification, and join our notification community so that you can excel your health and your life. In this video, we're talking about what is normal blood sugar. This is a really important topic because it affects everybody, not just people who are suffering from a condition, but everybody. And the reason for that is because it's estimated that the average person consumes over 130 pounds of sugar per year. This is 26 times more sugar than what people consumed 100 years ago. Now, you're probably thinking to yourself, well, that's not me. But a lot of people fail to recognize that 70% of packaged and processed foods contain sugar. And the other thing that people fail to recognize is that when you are consuming a lot of carbs, it's breaking down in your body as sugar. Now, here's the thing that is really important about all of this is that if you are able to recognize what normal is, you'll be able to, you know, start changing your ways. And if you understand that you're out of normal ranges, then you can start making those changes in your life today. So we're going to talk about what normal is and then what happens when you start to fall out of the norm and all the way down to actually having a health condition related to blood sugar. So first, let's jump into what normal is. So what normal is 80 to 100 milligrams per deciliter. This is referring to, taking a simple blood sugar test, fasting for 8 hours. This is your fasted blood glucose. Okay. Many people can go to a pharmacy. You can pick up these really inexpensive blood glucose meters, do it right in your home. When you fast for 8 hours and you take your blood sugar and it's in this range right here, that's an indication of normal. Okay. What this essentially means is that insulin is shuttling sugar into the cell for energy properly, and that the pancreas is actually producing enough insulin for your body to function correctly. Okay, now when you're in this normal range, you're gonna feel much better, your body's gonna function much better, and you're going to make sure that you preserve your body from facing all these different degenerative conditions that come out of having chronically spiked blood sugar levels. Now, a lot of people ask me, don't I need to actually consume sugar so that my blood sugar stays at the proper level and that my body has the energy it needs? And the fact is that you don't. And the reason for that is because your body's capable of breaking down carbohydrates for sugar, breaking down protein for sugar, and breaking down fat for sugar. So your body's actually going to be able to use those different energy sources and break them out and down as sugar to supply your body with adequate energy. You don't have to consume sugar in order to actually have proper energy levels. Now, when we're on this topic of normal, the other thing I want to mention is that people who have blood sugar instability, they can actually have what's called reactive hypoglycemia. Now, as a result of that, I talk about fasting all the time, for instance. I talk about one meal a day all the time. And when you have insulin instability, blood sugar instability, when you go into that fasted state, what can happen is you can actually drop below that 70 mark. So when you drop below that 70 mark, what can happen is you can get dizziness, brain fog, fatigue, and just not feel well at all. And so in order to actually jump into fasting, I always recommend that people are following a healthy diet, that they're doing the right things before they do that so they don't experience those different symptoms. So 80 to 100 milligrams per deciliter is what normal is. Now let's go to more the abnormal, okay? So 100 to 125 milligrams per deciliter is considered to be pre-diabetes. Now this is a big problem because 84 million people suffer from this. It's estimated 1 in 3 adults. I did put adults here, but you know, mind you, this is something that's a big problem with kids now. And it's estimated that if you have pre-diabetes for 10 years or more, it leads into full-blown diabetes. Now, the reason this is a big deal is because 84 million people fall into this pre-diabetes state. This is going to be a lot of people that you know. And the reason for this is because they're over-consuming carbohydrates, drinking a lot of sugary drinks, sugary coffees, you know, tons of sugary beverages, and it's causing all those issues that I talked about, advanced aging, it's causing the inflammation, it's driving degenerative conditions, and that's why we see so many degenerative conditions. I mean, if you were to just take sugar out of the equation and be able to pull the sugar problem from people, so many people would not be suffering like they are today. So sugar really breaks down the body in a big way, and that's really what I'm trying to, you know, instill in you. And so when you have pre-diabetes, some of the different symptoms are going to be a lot of fatigue, a lot of drinking a lot of water, feeling thirsty all the time, and also frequent urination, okay? And so after you fall into this state and you've had it for more than 10 years, then you fall into full-blown diabetes. We're not going to really focus on that too much because that is just a whole nother topic. A lot of people suffer from diabetes. The important thing that you need to know is that when somebody has type 2 diabetes, it is possible to reverse it. Many people are made to believe that there's nothing that you can do about it, but in fact, you can reverse diabetes type 2. And so anyway, guys, be sure to check out my other video on how sugar destroys the body, because it's really important, and this topic of sugar is a big deal. You know, if you can not only remove sugar from your diet, but also help a couple friends, you're gonna really be doing these people and yourself a huge service. Now, down in the description below, I included a link on my top strategies in order to help you balance your blood sugar so that you don't suffer from these different issues right here, and you're able to fall right into this category. Be sure to implement this. Check out my other video on sugar, and then also subscribe to my channel. I'd really appreciate it. Give this video a thumbs up and check out my other videos on how you can increase your health. I'll see you in the next video.